take that damn
really
turn coming out the airport
like
once the right way, bro. I had to swing that shit wide.
As you all know,
literally twice in a row, dude. I had to go out around by the Chinese restaurant.
Most of the damage to the same target, but then the side enemies take adjacent damage. So that means the brunt of Daniel's damage is going to be hitting that one enemy. So Cerulean was able to lower the resistance of some defenses up that
same enemy. Bigga, did you see me randomly flip over there? I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah, that's the
really
thing,
likes this character
like
as well,
I've done that,
like that
on the turn at the bottom
damage,
of Rockford.
Was there something there? I didn't
why
see anything.
So
it's like a little thing on the ground where the pole was.
Yang Qing is another great example.
Mr. Spock!
Damage, so he takes advantage of Cerulean, especially.
And then another time I was in college,
I FG a local go into that lane, I try to go to the left side, they only go into that lane to turn.
Because of the sheer flexibility of Clara. Now, here's the biggest part. We just made a video recently about this video going over Zui, I'm going to call her X-Y, right?
You know what?
She is a 4-star destruction monoclonic character, and she will help you achieve the 4-star monoclonic composition. So, if you wanted to pick up Silverwolf, now is a great time because they're giving us, not giving us a 4-star, you have to roll for her, but we're getting another option to help us achieve the 4 quantum member minimum requirement in order to get 100% right? You get people for free, Blinks as a 4-star character, you're going to be getting at some point, maybe you already have her, if you pay for Blue Shrine's banner, and heck, if you already have Blue Shrine's banner, so place where you have Blinks, and then getting then you will have all of those characters. And it is very, very nice.
Go Nappy! Right! Maxing in victory means playing the long game! Lend me your strength!
Have another turn to work with, so therefore you can save that skill point to use a basic attack, and then you can use your ultimate or elemental skill again. The soul is a character that has her own skill with a all of which is very nice and makes her a skill point positive damage.
I'm gonna probably keep racing. I don't want to run a
ability, hybrid damage dealer, offensive.
You know,
the best thing about this character is her weakness implant. This thing is going to absolutely just crush all content you bring her in. This allows you to work with your opponents to destroy the resistance of the enemy, and she allows you to play around the weakness system. The weakness breaking system is one of the strongest mechanics in this game because it allows you to just fundamentally ignore how the game is played, right? So essentially, if you have, let's say you have a team of one character, and you put that card in the enemy, if you have a few hits, that enemy's action is delayed, and then it takes a turn. Almost does massive damage. Or if you plan to play Silver, then you can build
liquidation! Lend me your strength!
Eliminating threat!
Go Nappy! Lend me your strength! To guard and defend! Crush them!
Damage.
My darling.
His implant effect. There is no other character in this game that even comes close to the
What the fuck is this?
Who is a character that is of the offensive blocking support category that pretty much acts like her a little bit? Now, if you already have Silverwolf, getting some of her Eidolons is a game changer for the gear. Getting your first Eidolon means you do not have to run your best as a 4-star light coming gear. Instead, you can offer something that gives more damage to the character, because whenever you use your ultimate, and that enemy already has a lot of people, you're going to get so much energy whenever you use your ultimate enemy, all of which is going to allow you to 6, you're going to turn her into a single target damage carry. She becomes one of the probably strongest single target damage duo in the game. Because this increases her damage greatly with the multi-damage stacking mechanic. And then this right here,
take caution.
Strong because she gets a 20% damage increase. Whenever that enemy has deep, this
and
is
really good,
absolutely
man.
Nuke enemies. You already have the quantum weakness of enemy, the enemy has their defenses, and you're just going to absolutely delete her. It is crazy how much damage she does at this point. So this is how you play her. If you plan to use her as a
begin. Confiscate it. Need a doctor?
Yeah. It should come back.
I'm okay.
Around this range, 61%, has been very nice and very reliable for landing all of those debuffs. There is still a chance that the enemy resists, but this has been very nice for me while keeping the crit rate. And I guess we should just go ahead and instead of our gym team. Yes. If you don't have Silver Wolf, I would.
Hey, you! Time to check your books. A little something for everyone.
Now, that's a trick.
Show your courage. Risk warning. Go nothing! The market is unprepared. Investing in victory means playing the long game! This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength. Easy, Numby. Riveter! Let me tend your wounds. I'm not afraid of you.
Annihilate.
I want to protect everyone too. That's your Sora. Evaluation begin. The market always fluctuates. Whenever you're ready. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend. Crush them. Liquidation! There's always a weakness. Decisive moment in the battle. Lend me your strength.
Eliminating threat.
I want to protect everyone too. Oh, that's your Sora. Go Nubby!
Mission command.
because they just didn't have the icon, and I didn't want to put some random character there. I'll just explain it, right? Just on, they benefit from one each, right? But without further ado, don't forget to like and subscribe as always, you know? Hit the like button, all that. Comment if you're excited for these new relics,
so
if you're not excited, and let's begin the video. So the first one is going to be
the follow-up attack damage.
This one increases follow-up attack damage by 20%. Then the 4-piece, when the wearer uses follow-up attack, increases the wearer's attack by 6% for every time the follow-up attack damage. Hits, you won't get the max buff. If I'm wrong, let me know. It sounds not really reasonable for certain characters. I think, like, what, bro, how many hits Himiko is? It's weird because I don't think anywhere it specifically states how many times they hit for. I think Lightning Lord hits all 8. Himiko might get close, but yeah, I have no idea how much Topaz hits for. I'm pretty sure it was like 6 or 7 last time I looked. Regardless of that, right? If you follow up attack again, you lose the buff, right? And you only get the attack up when you do a follow up attack. So characters like Clara, which are only gonna get the one follow up attack, and then they only get the one attack buff.
He was just going straight.
A little weird, right? I feel like this won't be an issue for Topaz, Himiko, and Jin, but someone like Clara, it's not gonna be great, I think. Remember how much they hit for them?
He
bubbled
me a little bit.
I'm pretty sure
he just enough speed
gets the max buff to make Topaz get kind of close. Yeah, Topaz would be up here as well. Now, let's get into the next one, which is my favorite one. Increases attack by 12%, right? Same thing as the cowboy setup right there. Then the 4-piece, for every DOT the target enemy is equipped with, the wearer will ignore 6% of the defense while dealing damage to it. This effect is valid for 3 DOTs. Man, oh man, that sounds really good. 12% attack, W, right? DOT ignore defense. If you see anybody showcase on MJ Will, you'll know that defense reduction is so strong that I actually recommend running Quantum on her. You do more damage. It's not an insane amount, but the max does more damage than the ice set just because of her going to bed. Insane, right? So you're probably gonna want this, right? And here are the characters that would pretty much benefit from it. Just Kafka, Luca, and they're probably the easiest to get. There's probably a lot of more DPSs that could get us as well. I just put the main three because it's really just like a universal one. As long as you hit the requirements, it'll be good, right?
This thing right
make sure you hit the requirements before you farm this up, though. Don't farm it up, and then you suddenly can't hit the speed thresholds, and then it's just not as good as you want it to be. But still, really, really nice. I also think design-wise, it looks absolutely sick.
I'm gonna get you some.
But yeah, very, very strong, which is kind of crazy because I'm thinking, are we gonna get anything like this strong anytime soon? Increases the wearer's energy regeneration rate by 5%.
Let me give you the keys.
Increases damage for all other allies with the same damage type as the wearer by 10%. Now, the only reason I don't like energy is that another one makes you attack 10%, and then it just gives you could probably use this. Your Don Hang. I think Pele and Jinglu are going to love this set so much. Also, Mono Quantum. I imagine you can do some funny shenanigans with running all three of them with this. But this one is pretty much if your support doesn't need their link rope, you can run this just fine. You're limited to mono teams, but another character, Asta, you probably like that.
High threat target ahead.
A little something for everyone. Show your courage.
Protect everyone too.
Who's your turn?
Risk warning.
Go nothing.
The market is unfair.
Nothing in victory means playing the long game.
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength.
Easy, I'm confiscated.
Always a weakness. Lend me your strength.
Let the valuation go nothing.
Eliminating.
Easy, Numby. Liquidation.
You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend. Crush them.
Let the valuation begin.
The market is on
right. Investing in victory means playing the long game.
Let me tend your wounds.
I'm not afraid of you. Look out!
Lend me your strength.
Go nothing.
I need to be brave.
Eliminating.
Liquidation!
up every single time you deal an instance of damage. So characters like Topaz and Numbi, where there's multiple hits going off at once, that's multiple stacks of this that you're getting. So it's actually fine that the effect is removed the next time you use a follow-up attack, because you're able to get multiple stacks of any attack. Now, with that said, it also means that certain characters actually don't use this very well. And it's also worth noting that there are already good sets out there for a lot of characters that use follow-up attacks. So who is it actually going to be good for? Well, the two-piece is going to be good across the board for most follow-up attack users. I would say characters like Clara can actually benefit from this a little bit just on the two-piece set, because it's going to increase follow-up attack damage, and follow-up attack damage is so much of Clara's personal damage that this could actually be an upgrade just to the two-piece. However, Clara wouldn't really benefit from the four-piece, because Clara has a tan multiple enemies, but without a tan, enough to actually be a strict upgrade. So something like two-piece follow-up, two-piece is good on her. Or even quantum set against quantum enemies. Like, you can, there's so many other sets you can use on Clara and get a lot of value out of. The only benefit she gets really, in my opinion, is gonna be shit. But there are a few characters that the four-piece can be good for, and one of those characters is gonna actually be Jingguan. So Jingguan's gotten some flack. I don't know what to say about it, really. So some content creators said Jingguan's not that good, and then some people that played Jingguan were, like, really mad about it, and so they kind of have to the content creators, and the content creators kind of weird. I don't really get it. I always felt like Jingguan was, like, fine. I just think air dishing itself is, like, not super good. But a lot of Jingguan's damage is follow-up attack damage. And because Lightning Lord can hit everyone and does a ton of instances of damage, you can actually stack up this attack like a ton. And between Lightning Lord's attacks, you're actually going to keep that attack bonus up until the next follow-up attack. So if you get a ton of attack, it doesn't seem like a massive increase in damage, probably looking at, like, 5-10% of the Lightning set, but it's still pretty solid. And you can benefit from this if you want to make your Jingguan stronger, so that's something to consider. I think Herta could also benefit from this a little bit, but she's probably going to be more optimized on speed, attack, and ice, like, mixed two-piece sets, just because she's really reliant on a specific thing happening to trigger her follow-ups. And it's
what
not
those things had, like...
Speaking of characters that no one plays, Himiko could actually benefit from this as well. As you know, during follow-up attacks, Himiko actually hits a fair bit of times. The downside is that Himiko's entire gimmick isn't just follow-ups, right? Her ultimate and skill are not follow-up attacks, right? So using two pieces of the fire set and then two pieces with mixed other sets is still going to be really good on Himiko, and I don't have the calcs for her specifically, but it is something to consider at the very least, because she does get a lot of hits in and can stack it up. The last character that's going to really benefit from this is Topaz, and I talked about Topaz a little bit already, but Numbi's going to deal a lot of hits with the follow-up attack, and since all of Topaz and Numbi's damage is follow-up damage once you get all of her traces unlocked, you're basically getting a flat 20% damage bonus, but you're also getting attack up pretty frequently. Now, the downside is that if you use just a regular Topaz attack and Numbi doesn't follow it up and you do a bunch of stacks, you will have, like, a round where you basically just have, like, 6% attack buff. It's not a huge deal. Like, overall, it's still an increase for Topaz, probably around 10% off of her last best-in-slot set, but it's not as consistent as it kind of looks like it would be. Overall, Ash Blaze and Grand Duke is going to be good. The two-piece is going to be good for Clara, and the four-piece set's really going to be good for Jingguan and Topaz. So that's going to be the Fire Blazing set. Let's talk about the next one, which is going to be for Dot characters. Now, I never thought Dot characters really had any issues with their relics. They already kind of dealt decent damage, but look at this. So two-piece, increase attack by 12%. Dot characters benefit from that. That's great. Four-piece set. For every Dot the target enemy is afflicted with, the werewolf ignores 6% of target's defense when dealing damage to them. The effect is valid for a max of 3 Dots. So this, to me, is, like, pretty crazy, because it's basically just defense ignore, right? You have a character that's a Dot character that adds a vulnerability, Gwynhyphen. You have characters that lower defense that are Nihility. You have a Light Cone that lowers defense. You have Light Cones that increase damage bonus. Like, one of the debates in the community was about whether or not you play buffs with Dot characters, but this is a pretty solid buff for Dot characters, as is. Like, you don't necessarily need to play absurd defense shred with them or anything like that. The characters that are going to benefit from the most, characters like Servant, who's an erudition, but, you know, basically could be a Nihility character if we're just going off of Dots alone. Kafka mains are going to rejoice and enjoy this a lot. Luca, Gwynhyphen, and the red that keeps showing up in my polls. All those characters are attack scaling, and all of them have Dots, so they can all benefit from this a fair bit, and likely it's going to be a damage increase
is timely. Unavoidable. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them. Lend me your strength.
Eliminating threat.
Let the evaluation begin. Go nothing. You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
I need to be brave.
Annihilate.
Even
I want to protect everyone, too. Help me, Mr. Sora.
The market is unprepared.
Nothing in victory. Even playing the long game.
Assistance is timely.
What's in your prescription?
Hide.
We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Easy, Numby. Go, Numby!
The market is unprepared.
Not even victory. Even playing the long game.
There's always a weakness. Lend me your strength.
Let the evaluation begin. Riveter!
Don't even try to explain it. Oh yeah, it increases the blood content in their bloodstream. Bro, just stop. Oh my god, dude. They actually had to explain it. This is so vile. I'm gonna puke.
begin.
This battle is unavoidable. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Need
a doctor?
Finally! Pretty good perk.
Time to question your prescription! I need to be brief.
You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
Easy, Numby.
The market is on
Christ! Nothing in victory means playing the long game!
And Tessa!
I'm okay.
Let
evaluation begin.
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Eliminating
crime.
Finally!
Ugh, great
apart! What is your prescription?
No,
the market is on
right! Nothing in victory means playing the long game!
You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
Protect everyone.
Oh, who's your Tara?
Let me tend your wounds.
And he told them anyway.
More. I think I was, again, jumping the gun a little bit. This is kind of hilarious, right? You can't eat them because they're people, but if you didn't know they're people and you were eating them, sure, no problem. So you are doing the problem. Face Jerry. Let's go. Jerry taking W's this season.
Morty, that was terrible.
Is it just veganism? Oh my god!
A little something for everyone.
Hey you, time to check your books.
Oh my god, dude, they are really going for it. Alright, let me just say, the least accurate part of this entire scene is the bank.
Target threat index raised.
Liquidation!
Right! Maxing in victory means playing the long game!
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength.
Easy, Numby.
Why are you doing this?
Pretty good perk.
Hide.
I want to protect everyone too.
Why would he follow them? Why?
Are you all
I'm okay.
your books. Show your courage. You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them. Liquidation! Unavoidable.
Easy, Numby. Go, Numby!
Hide.
I'm not afraid of you. I want to protect everyone, too. He knows your Sora.
Let the evaluation begin.
Liquidation!
Let me tend your wounds. You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength. The market is unprepared.
Nothing in victory. We've been playing the long game. Protect everyone too.
Oh, he knows your Sora.
We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Go, nothing!
Application authorized. Stay back, Clara.
I want to protect everyone, too.
Who's your Sora?
Hide this individual.
Need a doctor?
affect everyone too.
Homie Messers for him.
Evaluating variables.
We've entered the storm. To guard and defend. Crush them. Pay for this. Lend me your strength. We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Hide.
I want to protect everyone too.
Who's your turn?
Reinforce it.
soul, your nose is mine, reveal dimension shifter, and then chain dimension shifter. Yeah, you love to see it, baby.
Wonderful.
Oh, love that you get to do that. It's so funny, and we'll just get more gore, and we cut it alive. From here, we have a darken hand, we can draw a card. Even if we don't, we can make modern things. Sure. I'm just trying to find a way to rise in here, I imagine.
I wonder if going for Borger is always the choice there over Dr. Madeline. I think
that way they're not losing money. Two shifters,
probably not exactly.
Oh,
right.
Get double shifter.
People see shifter and treat it. Oh my god, the game's over. Shifters come down. No one can play through that. Effectively, if you have a shifter, it means the rest of your hand might not be.
Start to finish. Start, space, the number two, space, finish. Start.
Liquidation! Right! Nothing in victory, even playing the bomb game!
Lend me your strength.
Eliminating threat.
Enter the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Woohoo! Liquidation! Let me tend your wounds. Finally!
Thanks. I'll never forget
you.
You'll
pay for this. Lend me your strength.
I'm not afraid of you.
Let the valuation go nothing.
The market is unprepared.
Right. Investing in victory, even playing the bomb game!
enter the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
Annihilate.
Need a doctor? Finally!
Take back, Pirate.
I want to protect everyone, too.
Oh, that's your score.
Go nasty! The market of a...
Right! Investing in victory means playing the long game!
This battle is unavoidable.
Forget you.
Lend me your strength.
Pretty good perk.
What's in your prescription?
Liquidation.
I need to
eliminate.
You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
I'm not afraid of you.
Look out!
I want to protect everyone too.
Help me, Mr. Spara.
Easy, Numby.
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength.
Hide.
Let me take
it.
What's in your prescription? You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
I'm not afraid of you.
Look out!
Go nutty!
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength.
I need to be free.
We've entered the storm. To guard and defend, crush them.
The market is unpredictable.
Right! Investing in victory means playing the long game!
I want to protect everyone too!
Help me, Mr. Spara!
You'll pay for this. Lend me your strength.
I'm not afraid of you.
Need a doctor?
Liquidation!
This battle is unavoidable. Lend me your strength.
Go nutty!
You'll pay for this.
Hey, you! Time to check your books.
A little something for everyone! show your courage.